So when it comes to sine and cosine, what you always have to remember is they're basically opposites of each other because the adjacent and opposite can change depending on which angle you are, but they are also complementary to each other. So if you think about any right triangle, you always have all three angles add up to 180. And if 90 of them are at the right angle, that means these two angles, 1 and 2, will always add up to 90 degrees. So if I'm talking about angle 2, this would be opposite and adjacent, or opposite and hypotenuse. And if I switch it, I could also do that as the same thing as the cosine of angle 1, which would make this the adjacent over the hypotenuse. So the key thing is they are complementary. You can switch depending on what you need. The first part that it's going to ask you on some of the practice problems is just to find the write it in terms of cosine. So if I have the sine of 9 degrees, well, 90 minus 9 is 81. So that would be the same sine as cosine of 81 degrees. If I have the sine of 30 degrees, so 90 minus 30 is 60. So that's the same as a cosine of 60 degrees. If they give you cosine to start out with, remember you just subtract. So the cosine of 15, so 90 minus 15 is 75. So that would be the sine of 75 degrees. Then they're going to start having you do some problems to actually find sine and cosine. So if I was doing an example like this one, so if I wanted to find x and y, so I'm going to cover up the y part for now. So if I label the parts that I know, x would be my opposite side, 9 is my hypotenuse, so that means I'm going to deal with sine, since sine is opposite over hypotenuse. So the sine of 16 degrees is equal to x over 9. So I'm going to multiply both sides by 9 to get rid of it. So x is going to be 9 times the sine of 16 degrees. So if I use my calculator, I'm going to do 9 times the sine of 16 degrees, which is going to be 2.5. And then I'm going to switch and do the y. So y is my adjacent side. So I'm going to use cosine of 16 is y over our hypotenuse. So if I multiply both sides by 9, I get y equals 9 times the cosine of 16. So 9 times the cosine of 16 is 8.7. So anytime you have a problem that is dealing with opposite and hypotenuse, you can use sine. If you're using adjacent and hypotenuse, you're going to use cosine.